sunny gray skies over the Golden State, the latest example of extreme weather that President Joe Biden says is caused by climate change.
Extreme weather caused by climate change means stronger and more frequent storms.
Biden visited California Thursday to assess the damage caused by recent storms, to promise federal help, and to deliver a message.
We have to invest in stronger infrastructure to lessen the impacts of these disasters because they become cumulative in a sense. We've already allocated funding from the infrastructure law that I signed a year ago.
Biden says he's made other strides in fighting climate change with the recently passed Inflation Reduction Act, which directs nearly $400 billion in federal funding to clean energy. In a bid to meet the U.S. commitment under the Paris Agreement, which aims to curb global warming to less than 2 degrees Celsius. And he's promoted U.S. innovation in clean energy to reduce greenhouse gas emissions, which scientists say drive climate change. Sherry Goodman of the Wilson Center's Environmental Change and Security Program said the U.S. government has long seen climate change as a threat.
We have to understand it in terms of these compound and cascading risks, because one risk, wildfire-fueled storms, then has an impact on the next set of climate events, these extreme, these atmospheric rivers, and they all interact.
The burden, she said, should be shared by the government and the private sector, a message also delivered to global power players at the World Economic Forum. Biden sent his top climate envoy, John Kerry, to this week's meeting in Davos, Switzerland. John Scott, head of sustainability risk at Zurich Insurance Group, says separate groups must work together to fight climate change.
Solving climate change is kind of like the ultimate team sport. It isn't just coming from one sector. So it has to be governments, it has to be business, it has to be the finance sector working together to really address these really complex and systemic issues.
And Goodman said, change will take time.
You know, we can't just go cold turkey on fossil fuels. We're going to be using oil and gas for some time still.
But critics say leaders should be more aggressive, especially when it comes to confronting polluting industries.
We cannot fix this problem without strong government action, and that needs to start by confronting the fossil fuel companies that are at the heart of the problem and have sought to distract, deny, and delay for so long.
And some of Biden's political opponents, even some fellow Democrats, have blunted more sweeping legislation, arguing that those industries create valuable jobs. So is Biden doing too much or not enough? Time and temperatures will tell. Anita Powell, VOA News, Washington.